Okay.
Hello, I'm back. Thank you very much for sticking around. So excited about all of the people that played so far, and for Tyler for organizing this. This is so very special. I'm gonna talk through the thing I'm gonna do, and then I'm gonna do the thing that I'm gonna do. So I have this thing that I made called Cheat Codes, which is a sampler and a sequencer. And so what I'm gonna do is address the little pads here. So like if I press pads, like they make notes happen. But what I'm gonna do is press those pads, but with code instead of my fingers on the pads. I'm gonna use my fingers to write the code. This is not gonna be some kind of circus trick. So I am gonna use Tyler's port of Sequins to do this. And I really hope nobody minds me talking through before I start. I'm going to tell Cheat Codes that I'm in this like live code mode. I'm gonna set up some pads using Sequins. So I have three banks of pads, and I'm gonna create three banks of sequences. I'm only gonna do odds. And then what I'm gonna do is actually nest the sequins. So it'll go like 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 1, 3, 5, 7, 11, 1, 3, 5, 7, 13, so on and so forth. Gonna drop that in to all the banks. I am going to create a table of sequins to dictate how many like repetitions, like how many times these pads will iterate. I'm gonna do a phone number that nobody actually knows. And then I'm going to sequins this part of the phone number. What area code? Cool, I'm gonna do that for all three banks. And then I am going to sync the Norn's clock. And I'm gonna use a sequence to do the syncing as well. So I'm gonna just do these like little values. Yeah, I'm not gonna nest this sequence though. Cool. Rad. Right, oh, and I wanna track how many clocks I have. So I'm gonna make a table of clocks for each of these banks. Great, we're gonna get to the thing, which is playing. I'm going to be able to specify a target bank, and I'm going to pass it a sync value. So inside here, I'm gonna use my repetition sequence to say like, yeah, okay, so from 1 to whatever the number of reps in the banks rep sequence, do, let's see, I think the way it'll go is I'll create a pad, like a little local, so I'll pull a pad, and then I will tell my grid to press a bank pad down, and the bank is passed in through the target, and the pad is going to be this local P. I'm going to sleep for 0.05 seconds, and then I'm gonna lift the bank pad. So bank pad up, target pad. I think that should give me kind of a, and I'm just like doing this like live execution thing in Maiden. Thanks to Zach for bringing that in. And then, yeah, I'm just gonna make a little start function so I can pretty tersely say like start one. Then, let's see. I will create a clock. Clocks. for that bank. And I will tell it to play. And I will tell it which target, so bank 1, 2, or 3. And then I will tell it a sync value because play requires a target and a sync value, and that is going to be the returned sync value here. So that should all go, and then I'm going to turn up the volume here in the workshop. So if I do, I can hear my voice now. If I do start 1, yeah, okay, that made some sound. There it is. Hey, we got sound. Gonna do start 2 and start 3, and then I'm going to take a brief second to turn off the lights, light a candle, and then we'll start. Watching your friends. Thanks for being here. Also going to introduce a drum part. I think I will sing while I do that, because it is taking a second.
Thank you.
you. Goodbye, everybody.
Welcome to Flash Crash. Welcome to Flash Crash. Welcome to Flash Crash. We'll be starting soon.